Hello, this is Christy. Today we will look at some options for the page size and layout in Xara Designer Pro X. This is the latest version of Xara, and I am showing you how to change the page size. So when you start a document, if you want to start a document for print, as you know, Xara Designer Pro supports layouts and page links and text links and all that stuff. So you can use it for designing stuff for print or magazines or brochures and things like that, which you can do also in Adobe InDesign, for example. So first you start by creating a file, new, and you create a new document. So here you have the main and most used types of documents, but also sizes. So if I want to start with an A4 document, for example, you can choose A4 portrait. And this is your default. And here you go. You have a A4 sheet you can design stuff on. I'm just going to drag an object in here. So there you go. Now, if you want to change the size of the page once you've started, and maybe you've designed some stuff already and you don't want to copy and paste it into a new document, you can change the size of the document. So it's very easy to do that. Just right click on the page and change, click on page options. This will bring up the dialog that shows your page size, which is the one you have at the moment, A4. And you can select here if you want to choose a different one. Let's try maybe US letter, for example, and click apply. So that will adjust your page size, but it won't shift your content around, because if the size is different, then you will have to rearrange some of the stuff you've done. You have options for automatically resizing the content of your page when you change the size of the page. So let me show you how you do that. I have some text here, a paragraph of text, a title, and also an image. So I'm going to right click on the page here and choose page options. So my current page is A4, but if I cancel this and right click on auto fit to page first, then I have here option to reposition all of the objects on my page to adapt to the page size changes. And that means if I make my page smaller or larger, my objects will try and follow my size and resize automatically. So let's see how that works. I'm going to click auto fit all objects, and you can choose to fit just the width or both the width and height. So I'm going to set it to both width and height. Click apply. Nothing has changed so far. So let me just right click on the page now and choose page options. And I'm going to change from an A4 page to a smaller size page, maybe an A6, which will be smaller. So watch what happens when I resize this. My content has scaled down as well. What if I change the landscape? Let's to landscape. Click apply. You will see it's not so perfect. So if it cannot fit the content, it will at least just move it and crop it. So you will have to see if this works for you. Let's try and change back to an A4 size, apply. So now it has scaled everything up. So you can see it's a bit funny how it interprets the sizes of the object. So obviously it's applied some clipping here, so this may not be what you want. So always see if that works for you. And you know, in the best case scenario, and it's no wonder this option is off by default, the auto fit is off, because it may not work for everyone, and it may actually be more work to fix your document once it's doing all this automatic scaling instead of just manually doing it yourself when you have the new page size. So if I go auto fit to page, auto fit all objects, click apply, and now I will change my page to A6 again, landscape, apply. You will see now I have the freedom to just take my objects myself and select them all and resize them and rearrange them on my page the way I want, without clipping and without having it destroy my paths or paragraphs or everything. So this is one of the features you can do. Another way, if you don't really care about what you're going to print on, so maybe when you create a PDF at the end, you allow printing to shrink the document automatically or fit it onto a larger sheet, then you can actually manually change the page size. So in previous versions of Xara, you used to be able to just move your cursor to the edge of the page and drag. At the moment, it's still possible to do that, but you need to first unlock the page. So the way to do that is right click here on the page, click page options, and from here first untick this box, lock page size. This will allow you, once you click apply, to manually change the size of the page by clicking on the edge, the right edge and the bottom edge, by doing this like that. Okay, now another thing you may want to do is, for example, you want to create a custom page, but you need to know, and you know the dimensions you want to do. So the way to do that is, of course, right click on the page, click page options, and then select custom here. You see it's already selected custom because I have manually dragged the edges of my page and I've changed it here. But if you don't, let's say you have an A4 before, right? And you right click now, page options, and I choose custom, then it allows you here to set the width and height yourself. So let's say I want to have 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters, click apply, and there you go. My page has changed size to what I specified. Another options you may want to do is, if you want to design on a different colored page, not white, you can right click on this and go to page background and click edit page color. Now you can't change the color here because there's no color as it says. So you can click on this drop down and choose color. And now you can choose what color you want your page to be. So as you click and change your colors from here, you can see it changing on your page. So let's say we want a kind of a even black, that is fine. You can choose and then close. So this is going to be the color of your page. So now you can just design your stuff. Another tip, if you are designing a document for print, like a magazine or newspaper or brochure, and you have multiple pages, and especially if you're linking text across pages and everything, so you would like to have a different layout. In the default Xara layout, you see the pages one after the other. So as you scroll down, you go to the other pages. But you also can show the pages side by side. So you right click on the page, page options, and choose double page. So this will show the pages side by side like this. So you can even design stuff that, you know, goes across the edges, or you can see your publication like a normal newspaper, for example, with two pages. So this is very useful in that scenario. Thank you for watching. I hope this tutorial has been informative and useful for you. If you enjoy my videos, please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for next time.